don't care about my gear. Hello, everybody. It's Shug here, and I'm your hammock helper. Now, I haven't covered this subject since the year 2011, which was quite a while ago. The big question this week, and last week, and maybe the week before that is, can I use my sleeping bags in a hammock? Shug, do I have to have a top quilt? No, you do not have to have a top quilt. Now, using your sleeping bag in a hammock is just fine. I'm going to show you a couple of ways to make it a little bit easier, depending on your sleeping bag, all right? This is an REI zero degree mummy. It's kind of thin, very warm. This is a Western Mountaineering 20 degree sleeping bag. I love it. You can see it's a little bit wider than this one, wider in the shoulders. It's a little easier to get into in a hammock and zip up. This one is kind of tough to get in and zip up. This one has the zipper on the right side where I prefer it. This one has the zipper on the left side, which is a little bit harder for me because I usually get on my hammock from the right side because I sleep with my head to the right, feet to the left. But a lot of people start out in hammocks and they don't have top quilt and they get confused. Do I need one, Shug? No, you don't need one. Use your sleeping bag. You know, you can make that choice later. A lot of people stick with their sleeping bag so they can use their hoods. Now, getting zipped up in a sleeping bag in a hammock is a little bit of work. Some sleeping bags more than others. This REI zero degree, a lot of work to zip myself up in it. The Western Mountaineer in 20 degree, a little less. But what I like about a top quilt is when I got to get up and go or get out of the hammock, I flip it back and I'm out. Here, I got to unzip. You know, not a big deal, but it may be if you're in there and if you're a person that's slightly claustrophobic. So when you lay on a sleeping bag, sleeping on the ground, you're usually on a pad, all right? A lot of sleeping bags, you know, they have those down baffles. You do have down underneath you. So when you're laying on the ground on a pad, you don't have any air or anything flowing underneath you. When you're hanging in a hammock, all right, if you don't have something underneath you, you have cold air. Even on a summer night, you know, that air gets cool, it gets moist, depending on the conditions. You have air flowing underneath you, so you get chilled a little quicker than you would on the ground where there's nothing but that cold ground, but you have that pad insulating. Insulation in a hammock is a different beast. Now, I'm not scientific by any means. I learn all my stuff by trying, failing, and succeeding. What down is doing is catching the warmth from your body. All right, so let's say my hand is my body, and this hand is the top of a down top quilt or sleeping bag. You can see a zero degree is a lot thicker. There's more down. They call it loft. You know, 40 degree might loft this much, a 20 degree that much, a zero degree up to 4 inches maybe. What that down is doing is catching your body heat. It's the same thing that happens in ducks and geese while you can see them out in cold water and not be cold. It's catching their internal heat and holding it against them. So that said, when you're laying in a sleeping bag in a hammock, a lot of people go, well, Shug, I'm going to be fine because I got down underneath me. To a point. I would say if you're using a 20 degree sleeping bag and it gets down to 25 degrees or 30, you may get cold because what's happening is that down underneath you is getting compressed very flat. It'll warm you some, but you don't have that loft to keep you warm. So you may be warm on top, start feeling that chill underneath you, and it's not going to happen until about midnight or 2 or 3 in the morning, and you're going to start to feel cold. And then you're laying there, and you'll probably just lay there and put up with it. So you need a pad. I like an underquilt the best, but most of us own a pad. Put a pad in your hammock and put your sleeping bag on it. Again, but I know a few people who just, you know, their bodies burn hot, and they can just lay in their sleeping bag in a hammock in different weather and be warm. So that's just something that you're going to have to experiment and try. All right, got that out of the way. Let's move on to how to get in the sleeping bag in a hammock. This is sleeping bag in a hammock 2.0. All right, so I got the Western Mountaineering sleeping bag in the hammock right there. That's going to be my rig for the night. Now, my zipper's right here. So I'm going to go ahead and unzip it almost all the way. This zipper on this sleeping bag goes, oh God, like about 6 to 8 inches from the end of the sleeping bag. I'm going to unzip it pretty close to down there. Okay, this is the number one way I would recommend to try to get into your sleeping bag. Lay it in where it's going to be. Flip it open. All right? So here you have your hood and a bit of your sleeping bag even hanging over the edge a little bit. So I know I'm going to get in my hammock from this side. So I sit down on this part. I'm going to rotate, put my feet into that little foot box. Now at this point, some of the sleeping bag has scooched up under me. So I'm going to pull it up. I'm going to zip up a little bit. I'm going to sit up and try to get this hood back behind my head. All right? There. So now I've got my hood up. So I know my sleeping bag is fully around me. And now, because this is a fairly roomy sleeping bag, more room you have, the easier it is to do. All right? So I'm in. I got my hood. I got my hood cinched. So in this mode, when I want to get out, unzip, I'm going to go ahead and let my hood out. That to me is the most simple way to do it. Okay, here's the second way to do this. And it works. Take your sleeping bag, you stand in it. You put your hood up over your head. Reach down. You zip yourself almost all the way in. Then you sit down. I definitely want an arm out, catch myself if I fall. And I get in this way. And then I go ahead and squirm around until I get that zipper all the way up. That'll work. Just put yourself, you know, if the ground is wet, you know, you got to put something down. Put your sleeping bag on, you know, a piece of foam pad, or you don't want something too slippery because then you'll fall while you're in that thing. So that's a way to do it. This is my hammock gear 20 degree top quilt. It looks like a sleeping bag, but here it is looking from the back. It has a foot box in it. There's no zipper. It's a lot easier to use in a hammock. But of course, because you have no down under your back, you definitely need a pad or an underquilt. So my normal MO when I get in a hammock, throw my top quilt back, I just grab that top, I slip my feet in that foot box, and then you take your top quilt and you tuck it in around it. Alright? Now there's no hood on it, so this is why I wear a balaclava, which I'd wear with a sleeping bag anyway, and I'll have a beanie like what I'm wearing on, maybe a black rock hat, and then I have a detached down hood off an old jacket that I put on my head. So that takes place of my hood. And what you can certainly do is use your sleeping bag in top quilt mode. So what I'm going to do is I have it zipped up to where it's just going to come like kind of right up behind my knees. Now, not a bad idea to take a piece of tape or something. If you're going to use it this way, put it over your zipper. Some people have worried about that poke in their hammock. I've never had it happen. That's not to say it can't, especially if you have a light material. Now I'm throwing the sleeping bag in, the 0 degree REI, and I will use it in top quilt mode. Meaning I just slip in it, same way I did. Now you can definitely take that extra bit of bag, tuck it up under you. The great thing about these is you can still access your hood. Okay, so I got my hood here. The thing is, I can tuck this around, still get that hood on my head. But basically what I'm doing is I'm using my sleeping bag without zipping it up. It's really just my upper middle back that I feel a little chill on. So, but I got the hood on and I can definitely still reach around. There we go. And get a lot of the bag under me, but not mess with the zipper. Because what I like about that is when it's time to get out, I can just get out. That's kind of using a sleeping bag in top quilt mode. But the best thing for you to do is get out there and see what works for you. Sleeping bag, yes. Hammock, yes. It'll work, do it. All secure in Sector 7, woo buddy.
I need to see her, yeah, before I lose my mind. It feels like retribution for something I know I've done. Lord, I'll be tearing myself apart till I find out what I'm guilty of. Oh, what I'm guilty of.
Sector 7 is secure.